Using OneDrive without using OneDrive. Hi everyone, Leo Notenboom here for askleo.com. OneDrive is controversial, to put it lightly. Their backup feature is a mess. The way they manage storage seems questionable at best and a ham-fisted marketing technique at worst. But regardless, you've got 15 gigabytes of free online storage. A terabyte if you've also got Microsoft 365, which is useful for things like sharing, if nothing else. Let's see how we can do that without messing up our computer. You do not need to run the OneDrive app on your computer. You can disable it, you can install it, you can sign out of it. Any of these will prevent the OneDrive app from trying to synchronize or otherwise manipulate any files on your computer. This is the OneDrive we're not going to use. With the OneDrive app not in use, there won't be any confusing manipulation behind the scenes. And if we take a look here on my machine, if I go down to the notification area, you can see that, yeah, OneDrive icon isn't there. The app isn't running. The Google Drive icon is there and a couple of other things, but OneDrive itself, it ain't happening. Great. So what we do instead is we go to OneDrive.com. Now, you may be asked to log in with your Microsoft account because that's what gives you access to your OneDrive. But the thing to realize about OneDrive is, in a sense, it is first and foremost a website. That there might be other tools that work with it, such as the OneDrive app on your computer, it's nice, but it's not required. As you can see here, in the recent view, that's what this is all about, it's showing me some files that I've used recently. If I want to take a look at all the files in my OneDrive, well, we click on My Files. My Files basically opens up what boils down to a directory structure, not unlike what you have on your computer, that you can organize and store things in and do things. So once you locate a file within your OneDrive, which we can do by doing things like just clicking on a folder, and sure enough, in my OneDrive, my Word Documents folder, I have three documents. If I want to download those documents to my PC, I simply right-click on it and click on Download. And sure enough, it downloads like any other file. Now I can operate on that file on my computer if I want to. If I want to add a file or upload a file, well, that's what this new and upload is all about. I'll click on new and upload, and you can upload a number of different things, but for this basic overview, I'm just going to upload a file. I have lots of files I could choose from. I'm just going to go ahead and upload this list.txt because it's available. Before I do that, though, realize that what we're looking at here is a traditional file open dialog box that allows you to locate files anywhere on your computer that you can then choose to upload to OneDrive. Like I said, I've chosen list.txt. I'll click on open and poof, it's been uploaded and it's been placed in my Word documents just because that was the folder I had open at the time I did the upload. Great. We can download files. We can upload files. That's a lot, to be honest. I mean, that's really all you need to use all of this online storage you've got available. But there's more. One of the reasons you might want to use OneDrive.com, even without the app running on your PC, is to be able to share a file or folder with someone else. Now, I'm going to move over to a different file because it's something that actually makes sense to share. I have this Internet Safety Free Edition in PDF form in this OneDrive. So I'm going to right-click on it. This time I'm going to click on Share. This opens a dialog that allows me to either choose who I'm going to share it with or just get a link that I can then share with anybody I want to myself. The catch and the thing to be aware of is that the default you'll see for either of these is anyone with the link can edit. We don't want that. I just want them to be able to see the file. I don't want them to be able to make changes to the file. So we'll click on that and click on this More Settings and View. We'll hit Apply. And there's the link. We'll copy it. And now I can paste that in an email. I can paste it in an instant message. I can paste it in a text. I can do whatever I want to with that link. And the recipient of that link will then be able to see the document that I have just shared with them. One way I'll prove that to you is by opening up an in private window so that I'm not logged into anything. And I will paste that link. You can see it's a fairly long link. Poof. And it opens up Internet Safety V6 free, the document. I can either, or they can either download it or open it right there online and view its contents. Now, one of the things that's interesting is that, of course, OneDrive is integrated with the rest of the Microsoft ecosystem. On your PC, that can be annoying. But online, it can be kind of interesting. If I go back to My Files and go to My Word Documents, I can download these documents and make changes to them on my PC. But I don't have to. They're Word documents. There's Word, a free version of it, available online. So instead of downloading, if I just click on it, it automatically opens Word Online. And now we can edit the document to our heart's content. And once we close the document, it'll be updated in our OneDrive. This works for basically any Microsoft Office document type, Word, Excel, PowerPoint, and others. Kind of handy. All right, so far we've downloaded files, we've uploaded files, we've shared files, and we've edited files online. All pretty powerful stuff without ever having involved our PC. One of the things that happens on your PC if you run the app is you sign in to your Microsoft account so that the app knows which OneDrive you're playing with. But we're not running the app. We just signed into OneDrive.com online. Well, that means that it doesn't even have to be your PC. You can sign in to OneDrive.com from any PC. Of course, making sure to keep your Microsoft account credentials secure. In private and incognito would be one approach, but it depends on your situation. There's also no requirement that this be a PC. You can visit OneDrive.com from any computer with a browser running any operating system. Windows, Mac OS, Linux, Google Chrome, and probably a bunch that I just can't think of. Now, there is one downside that I want to be clear about. If you're placing sensitive data in the cloud, I often recommend making sure that it's encrypted. My tool of choice is Cryptomator, but that's software that runs on your PC, not in the cloud. Cryptomator encrypted files are not accessible via the web interface. Another approach is to encrypt files manually, say with a password-protected zip file. You'll still need to download, decrypt, edit, re-encrypt, and upload to make changes, but it's at least feasible and doesn't require anything other than a zip program. So, use OneDrive on your PC or not as you see fit, but now you understand. You can use it completely via the web without any of that synchronization and background magic. Hope you found that helpful. For updates, for comments, for links related to this article and more, visit askleo.com/176754. I'm Leo Notenboom, and this is askleo.com. Thanks for watching.